Hello, aspiring data analysts. Welcome back to Solution Unlocked channel. In today's video, we are diving into task 3 of the Tata Forage Internship program, where the data analysis adventure begins. Task 3 challenges you to unravel complex datasets provided by Tata and extract meaningful insights. This real-world scenario will sharpen your analytical skills and give you hands-on experience with Tata's data. Let's kick off task 3 by skipping the first page, using the next button and checking the background page. Before diving in, let's gain a complete understanding of the task. In the first phase, data cleaning is emphasized and the conditions are set. Number 1, quantity should be greater than or equals to 1, and the second is the unit price should be greater than 0. As we scroll down, there are 4 questions associated with the data visualization phase. The exciting part is that they have provided visualization hints at the end of the page, easily accessible through a simple download. So now you have 2 options for data cleaning phase using Excel or Power BI ETL. In this video, we will cover both. So stay tuned and let's begin with Excel. Now, first open the file in Excel and check the values in the quantity column. See, there are some negative values. So remove negative values to prevent errors in the data visualization chart. Insert columns after quantity and unit price and then rename them for the future use. And use the formula that is equals to if range and your condition, comma, true or false. After applying the formula, see again 6. Verify if it is included. Then it's done. Double click to apply it to all full column. Cross check to ensure exclusions for negative values. Now apply a similar approach to unit price condition for data cleaning in Excel. Cross check by filtering negative values and it's all done. Next, we will explore the same task in Power BI to elevate your skills. Stay tuned for more pro tips. A free tool, once installed, open it and you will find the Get Data option in the toolbar at the top left corner. This feature allows you to upload data from various sources, making Power BI highly popular. Click on Excel and upload your Tata data. The upload might take a minute. Once done, a screen will appear. Check a box and press Transformation. Power BI will then navigate you to the Power Query page, a versatile space for multiple tasks. Currently, we will tackle the 2 conditions we previously handled using Excel. Click on the right side triangle on the quantity cell, choose number filter and set the condition to greater than or equals to. It's that simple. Select your condition, set the numeric value and press OK. Repeat a similar process for the unit condition, but here only the greater than condition is needed, so no AND or operation will be applied on it. Here's a quick tip. Always rename the applied steps bar in Power Query. It will be beneficial for future access, helping you remember the specific condition applied, like quantity and unit cell. Once done, choose the close and apply button at the left top corner. Hooray! You have completed the ETL phase using Power BI. Back on the dashboard page, you will find the data bar on the right side where your uploaded data appears each time. Clicking on it reveals the column list in the data sheet. Here I noticed that the revenue column is missing. So if you don't know the revenue formula, you can Google it. Add a new column and input the formula. The revenue formula is revenue is equals to sales into unit price. Setting it as currency, explore the various bars in the toolbar such as sum, average, decimal, decimal number, whole number and more. Hit enter and the revenue bar will now be visible in the data section. Now let's quickly create a chart for a clear understanding of how to add one to the dashboard. Select the line chart from the left visualization bar and drag and drop the invoice data on the x-axis. When you select the invoice date, it will show 4 factors: day, month, year and quarters, providing a clear understanding of the data. Then drag and drop the revenue and witness the beauty of Power BI dashboard. You can also add a table and input whatever data you wish to display in it, such as relation between country and revenue. Let's initiate the data visualization task. In line with the CEO request, the first question involves creating a time series against revenue for the year 2011. To achieve this, we choose line chart for the visualization bar. Then we drag and drop the invoice date on the x-axis, selecting only months. Simultaneously on y-axis, we drag and drop the revenue. And just like that, our initial visualization is complete. Furthermore, Concerning the second query, the CMO is keen on examining the top 10 countries that contribute the highest revenue along with the quantity sold, excluding data from United Kingdom. To address this, we selected clustered column chart since there are two factors to analyze. Simply drop the country into the x-axis and quantity and revenue into the y-axis. Upon left clicking on the quantity, you will observe that we need to select the sum, and the same applies to the revenue. Continuing, the CMO aims to access details about the top 10 customers based on revenue. He specifically desires a visualization that displays the revenue in a descending order, emphasizing the highest revenue generation customers. To achieve this, simply choose the chart, drag and drop the values accordingly. Within the visualization chart bar in Power BI, there are format visualization bar offering various options to explore. I encourage you to give it a little bit more time. The more time you invest in exploring Power BI, the more it will enhance your dashboards. For the final visualization, the CEO aims to gain insights into product demands across countries and identify regions with the highest demand. Following this requirement, let's choose the map option from the build visual bar, place the country in the location bar and quantity in the bubble size. This way you can analyze which countries have higher demand for product, with the size of bubbles indicating the quantity demanded. Now let's bring together all the visualization to create a visually appealing dashboard. Feel free to add more visuals like cards and KPIs if desired, and share it with your fellows data enthusiasts. Join the conversation in the comment section below. Share your insights, challenges in the task 3. Let's build a supportive community of data enthusiasts.